What types of diverter valves are used in hydraulic piping? Hi, I'm Rachel. In this video, I will walk you through the most common types of diverter valves, and at the end, I have a useful list of 7 factors for you to keep in mind when deciding on which diverter valve is right for you. So, stay tuned. And before we go ahead, subscribe to the Kramp channel and turn on notifications to stay up to date on all of our informative videos. Hydraulics is all about the flow control of a fluid. This flow control is necessary in order to direct oil in and out of one system into another, so that one or two applications, for example, behind your tractor, can receive transmission and you can control the machines from inside your tractor cabin. Valves manage the fluid flow, so they're a crucial part of any hydraulic system. You need to be sure that you choose the right one to suit your needs, because picking the wrong one can damage your machinery. So, which one do you use in piping? Two of the most common types are two-way diverter valves and three-way diverter valves. First, let's have a look at two-way ball valves. They are called ball valves because there's a ball inside with a hole inside of it. You can direct the flow of the oil depending on how the ball is turned. These are commonly used as shut-off valves. They're simple and reliable, with two ports on which a pipe or tubing is connected to the valve. A two-way ball valve enables you to direct oil in one way from inlet A to outlet B, or the other way around. So, whenever you want to use a single working function behind your tractor, adding a two-way ball valve to your hydraulic system is a good option. Next, we move on to the multi-port valves, such as the 3-, 4-, and 5-way diverter valves. The most common one of these is the 3-way diverter valve. It has 3 ports that are connected to piping or tubing, and it can solve more complicated flow control issues than 2-way valves. For example, when you want to use 2 applications behind your tractor, you'll need to be able to control the flow with a system that allows you to switch between the two. Where 2-way ball valves make use of a ball, most 3-way valves include a pipe-shaped spool with holes in it in its inner workings. They are most often used to allow flow from one inlet port, that is, the tractor, out into 2 different outlet ports, for example, the 2 applications. This allows you to manage flow by either turning the flow to the left or to the right, with a 90-degree turn of the handle in manually operated systems, or a flick of the switch to operate the solenoid in an electrical system. Because multi-port diverter valves have more than one hole, it allows the system to let oil in and out at the same time, enabling you to switch between machines very easily. This is something you need, for instance, with a double-acting hydraulic cylinder. So, diverter valves come in many different shapes and sizes and can serve all kinds of systems. How do you find the one that's right for you? Here are 7 questions you should ask yourself. Number 1, what kind of actuation do I need? Does it need to be hand-operated or electrically actuated? Number 2, what's the maximum working pressure, meaning the pressure value for which the valve is rated for safety reasons? Number 3, how many positions will the valve need to support? By this, I mean the number of 90-degree turns the handle should be able to rotate in a manually operated system. 2 positions are 90 degrees, 3 positions are 180 degrees. Electrically operated valves turn by shifting the spool within the solenoid either to the left or to the right. Number 4, how many ports do I need for inlet as well as outlet? Number 5, what's the right valve size for my machine? That is to say, what's the maximum flow that will be going through the valve? Keep in mind that the return flow of a hydraulic cylinder can be bigger than the inlet flow. Number 6, what's the minimum and maximum temperature that the valve must be designed to accommodate? And finally, number 7, what material does the housing need to be? Valves can come in a variety of materials, each with their own characteristics. Within the agricultural industry, we mainly use cast iron, which is incredibly strong. Another common option is aluminium, which, for example, is light, has good thermal conductivity, and is resistant to oxidation. If you know of any additional considerations that could be helpful to others, please share them in the comments below. You might also want to check out our video on quick release couplings and what to do when they leak. Finding the right diverter valve for your agricultural machine or tractor can be a challenge, but ultimately, it's well worth the effort. Check your manual and do your homework. All right, to sum it all up, two of the most common types of diverter valves are the two-way ball valve and the multiport valve. If you're trying to decide which type of diverter valve you need, consider the seven factors. All right, everyone, that's it for now. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe button and check out our other videos. Thanks for watching. Cheers.